Hey, this is Josh McClain with channelfireball.com, and I'm drafting the new set today. So here's our first pack. This rare is very good, very likely what I'm going to take. All the gold cards are also pretty good, I think, but I don't like picking them early just because I like to stay a little open. This card is also just very splashable. Otherwise, I like this card a lot. The Leopard's very good. Chandra's Revolution is obviously solid removal. Precise Strike is better than I thought it was going to be. It's still like not great, but it's definitely very playable. I like Renegade Map 2. It's just an easy, obviously it's like good if you're splashing, but it's a very easy revolt enabler, and it also gives you something to improvise with. So, but I'm definitely taking the Battle at the Bridge here. So let's see. I haven't actually got to play with this card yet, but it doesn't seem great to me. This card is very, very good. Just like a giant fireball. Let's see. Otherwise, I like Poisoner a lot. The Herder's pretty good too. I don't really like the white one. The white one's like 4-mana, 2/3 Vigilance, but I like all the other energy servo guys. Chaser's great. I'm pretty sure I have to take Onslaught here though. Onslaught is just very, very good. Otherwise, there's not much else in this pack. I like this card a lot. I would never take it this early. Same with like Brawler, or I like the Implements a lot too. So I'm gonna take Onslaught. Leopard is good. Thopterus is very, very good, but obviously it's not exactly what we're looking for right now. Doesn't mean I'm 0% to take it. This guy's okay. I'm pretty sure I'm gonna take the Leopard though. I think Leopard's pretty good. It's like, it's kind of weird because it's hard to really, I mean, you really have to have other energy producers for it to be like actively very good. It's just, you know, 2/3 for 3 is obviously not great, but even just triggering once is good though. Then if you have more energy, it's just, I mean, a 4/3 trampler for 3 is great. So, yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and take the Leopard. Okay, so here's another Monstrous Onslaught. I'm definitely taking that card. It's just, yeah, it does what I think it does. It's very, very strong. This card is also very good. It's another Tampering. This card is not nearly as good as the old one. Sludge Crawler, I think it was called, the one with the Devoid. And then it ingested when it hit them for 1. That was much better. So I think artifacts and ingesting were more important. Obviously, there's no ingest in this block. So but yeah, I'm definitely taking the Onslaught here. I need good creatures to go with my Onslaughts. This guy's like not great because you have to attack to get the +2/+0. And then if it dies in combat, you just don't have a 4-power creature anymore. Okay, that card's pretty good. Oh, it has to be an artifact. I read that it's artifact or creature. Okay. It still might be pretty decent. I don't know if I really have any artifacts right now, but I think I'm gonna take Unbridled Growth. I like this card a decent amount too. It's really good at enable. It's basically a free roll to enable Revolt. I don't have any Revolt cards right now, but that's likely to change, I think. And if I don't take that, it's like probably this card, but I don't think it's that great, so definitely taking Growth there. And even if we end up like green, blue, or green, you know, green something that's not black, the Unbridled Growth will help me splash battle. So yeah, this pack is not great. I think I'm just gonna take the Swooper here. It's like that or maybe the Night Market Aeronaut. Maybe the Aeronaut's a little better. I don't really love Aeronaut that much though, but it is kind of on color and yeah, it's not a bad card. We did just get Unbridled Growth to help the Revolt out. I guess I'll take the Aeronaut. It's a very late Aether Chaser. This card's actually very good with Monstrous Onslaught. I like this one a lot too. This card's pretty good as well, but I don't think I want to take a white card at this point. It's possible I should just take Aether Chaser. You know, and just not play this. Aether Chaser is a very, very good card. I think I'm going to take the Aether Chaser. It's just so much better than all the rest of these cards. And hopefully that means red is pretty open. There's a few cards I want in this pack. I think both the automatons are very good. They just give you stuff to do, you know, with all your mana later in the game. I think the red one's a little better because that effect is much, much more necessary in, like, you know, a red-white aggro deck or something. Like, oftentimes you'll get them to, like, four or five and you just need a way to finish them off. Whereas this green, this is just making another big creature, and you already have a lot of big creatures. I think I'm going to take the Rebel, though. Rebel plays very well at the onslaughts, and it's just a pretty good card. Let's see. Probably taking Precise Strike here. I don't think any of the rest of these cards are too good. Decommission's okay, but obviously I'm not in white. I could take the Assembler. I think this card's kind of bad, though. I haven't really tried to play it yet. I'm just going to take Precise Strike. It's a Tampering. I expect these to wheel for a while. I think, I'm not sure if they should be wheeling or not, because, like, they are pretty replaceable. Well, not replaceable, but, like, you can't really have too many of them, so it's not like they get picked super highly, but the card is very good. This pack is not great. I'll take Crawler here. I think Crawler's okay, but it's not fantastic. I like this card. Deck's looking not too bad. Double Monstrous Onslaught is going to be very, very good. Just need a lot of good creatures now. Big creatures. I really like Solemn Recruit, but not quite what we need right now. And Aether Poisoner is actually pretty good. If I can play a pump spell and then a Monstrous Onslaught, I can just kill all of their creatures. But I think I'm unlikely to be playing enough black to do that. I expected green to be more open after we got it was fourth pick Monstrous Onslaught, but it kind of dried up after that. I guess the packs were just kind of bad, actually. I kind of want to take the Saddleback because it's so much power with my onslaughts, but there's almost 100% it'll wheel. There's just nothing I want in this pack. I guess Garrison. Garrison's okay. I didn't see this. I saw it. I just didn't consider it for some reason. But I'm going to take Garrison here for sure. And then hope to wheel the 5/4. These white cards are so good. But that ship has kind of sailed. Ooh, this is good with... I guess it's not great. It's just kill two of their creatures. If you get a plus one Swing Guard on this and then can onslaught. I think I'm going to take it, though. It's just like a solid creature. It trades with anything early, and then if you can get a plus and plus one counter on it, it attacks pretty well too. Oftentimes they'll have to, at least in like the early to mid game, they'll have to double. Oh, I didn't even see a train here. Jeez, this card is insane. Yeah, I'm definitely taking this card. But what I was saying about this is oftentimes if you can get it to be a 2/3, you know, three toughness sometimes a lot of times means they have to double block it. So then you have death touch, you can just kill both their guys. Once they have to start blocking, that is. So I'm definitely taking the train, though. It makes me less likely to play Garrison, just because I don't want to play too many vehicles, but so that's the energy guy there. I think I'd still rather take this. Even though I have these double onslaughts, I still want to just take the better card. That's pretty much all that I really care about in this pack. I wouldn't mind getting one High Spire Infusion, especially if I get more of these, you know, the servo energy guys, then I'll take a couple of those if I can get them. This card's really good, too. Maybe this is better, actually. I've never played with it, but it reads very good, and I've been told it's very good, so I'm sure it's actually great. Let's see. There's two pump spells in this pack, so I feel like one of them's probably going to wheel. Like, yeah, this card's much better than this card, but they are kind of similar, whereas like this creature is like fairly unique. I'm gonna take that. I like this card a lot. I don't have that many things with counters on them, but it's still a 3-3 trampler for 3, which is very strong. Otherwise, it's like Chandra's Revolution or Gear Smasher. It might just be the Revolution here. I am a bit short on creatures, though. I have like 5 creatures right now that can power my... like I have 2 vehicles and then 2 removal spells that rely on me having creatures. So I think I really have to limit the number of spells in my deck. I don't think removal is my problem right now. It's gonna be lack of creatures. So I'm just gonna go ahead and take the 3-3 for 3. Ooh, this card is very, very good. It goes very well with Malthus Revolutionary. I'm gonna take the fox. Or I guess it's a monkey, not a fox. Kind of looks like a fox at a glance. It's especially good with these chasers. Just getting a +1/+1 counter on a first strike creature is really important. Ooh, this guy's really good with my double onslaughts. That being said, I think I might actually take it. It's like that, or I don't think I can play just... well, I might be able to, depending on if I don't take like any more spells, I could play Destructive Tampering. But like I was saying before, I really need to max... like, I think this deck needs more creatures than a normal deck. So I'm going to take the Construct here. It's another Construct. I might just take Spider. Spider is pretty good, I think. Especially in a deck that's a little aggressive, because... they're going to have to be blocking and trading a lot. Whereas, like, if your deck is defensive, it's so much harder to turn on revolts, because you're often when things are trading, you're going to be on the blocking side, obviously. So like, all your sorceries and creatures with revolt, it's so hard to trigger them. But when you're attacking, it's much easier. So I'm going to take this spider. Lifecrafter's Gift is really good. It's another spell though, but there's nothing else. God, this card is very, very good. It's very late. White is clearly like kind of open, but I'm gonna take the gift. There's that. I'm not sure if I'll play both the Sailback and the Prizefighter Construct, but you never know. Yeah, I'm definitely not playing 2 Tamperings. I probably won't even play 1. I don't really need Tampering when I have Onslaught, I feel like, because Onslaught's going to clear the way most of the time. That might not be true. I'll keep one in there for now. So here, Infusion Wield out of that pack with the... it also had the red pump spell in it. I think Infusion's pretty good, because I have Leopard and 2 Chasers, so like I can definitely make good use of the energy. So right now I have 3 pump spells. I'm almost certainly not playing all 3. If I don't get too many more things with +1/+1 counters, I'll probably cut the Lifecrafter's Gift. Right now I've got just the there's another Weaver. Right now I've just got like the... where is it? The 2-drop. And I think that's it. There's another Tampering. I'm going to take Implement, though. I guess that was bad. I could see myself boarding in both the Tamperings. It's also a draft league, so I guess if that was completely wrong. I'm still just kind of in the mindset of normal drafts, where I would rather my opponent have a Destructive Tampering than an Implement, just because I feel like I'm most of the time going to be the aggressive one, and I'm not going to be both racing and like... rather, I'm not going to be like trying to play an attrition game where I'm just like trying to set up all these blockers. So I don't think Destructive Tampering is very good against me. Not that Implement's particularly good against me either, but it's just like a solid card that it's way more likely for, I think, my opponent to play than Tampering. But, as I said, it's a draft league, so that just doesn't matter at all. And also, the Destroying Artifact is like... could be very, very good, so it's very possible I want to board up to 3 of them, so that was bad. All right. Well, Rashmia is fairly insane. Let's see what else is in this pack. Fretwork Colony is interesting with Onslaught. I guess I'm not. I'm just splashing black, so that's not too important, but it like just grows really big, and then you can kind of kill everything. This pack is not great for me. I don't really like this card that much. Hunt the Week's very good, but again, I need creatures, not spells. I might just take Rashmi and not play Battle. I think that's kind of insane, though, because Rashmi's like very good in slower decks. My deck's not the slowest. I guess my deck isn't necessarily super aggressive either. Like, I can't just build up a big board and then with double Onslaught, probably like be favored for a longer game. Yeah, I think I'm gonna take Rashmi. It's so weird giving up. I mean, it's also possible I could double splash. That's in Prelus. I think I'm actually just gonna take Hunt the Week. Hunt the Week's pretty good, especially with my Revolutionary and my Lifecrafter's Gift. I don't feel great about that one, but I think it's right. This pack is pretty bad too. I really wish I'd taken Rashmi, and then I would just take Whirler Retrosa. Yeah, that would have been so much better. I guess I'll take Sage. Like I said before, the energy is actually like pretty good, so it's not a horrible pick. And it crews both my vehicles. So. It's crew two, right? Yeah. Artist is okay. Charger is okay. There's just no I would love the four drop. That's 3/3. Fabricate, Pima Outrider, like that card would be perfect. It's like a big creature for Onslaught, it's a plus and plus one counter. That said, I think I'm just going to take Spontaneous Artist here. So this is 25 cards already, only 13 creatures. That's way, 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 way too many spells. God, it's crazy that this guy's actually like very good in my deck, I think. Well, pretty good. Like, I'm definitely taking it over Hunt the Week here. That's so weird. But I'm fairly confident in that pick. So yeah, there's like, let's see, cards that I would consider cutting right now. Basically any of the spells, I think. So I have 1, 2, 3 pump spells. I definitely want to cut a pump spell. I think it's just the gift. It's just the most expensive one. Like, I have some synergies with it, but I'd rather my tricks just be cheaper. I think I'm gonna cut Tampering too. So I don't think I need it with double Onslaught. Just gives me 14 creatures and 24 cards. So I still have to cut one more card from here. But I kinda like where the deck's at. I could cut this, I think. Ooh, Armorcraft Judge. Ooh, Rip Tiger. Tiger is very, very good in my deck. I'm definitely taking this card. Even if I have to Onslaught before attacking, it's still 4 damage. And if I ever get to attack and then Onslaught, it's just going to be great. Can this go to a player as well? I think it's just creatures, right? Target creatures, yep. Yeah, I'm going to take the Tiger here. Another card that would be perfect would be the gold card for red-green. I could take an Attune. It is another spell, but I'd rather play Attune than... like Unbridled Growth, I think. I guess I do have 2 Silkweaver Spider, but I don't think triggering them is going to be that difficult. Could also just play Infiltrator. It's good with my 2 vehicles. I guess actually I would probably play both the Tune and the other thing just for my Black Splash. I'm gonna take it. Just take it. Take down to sideboard. I don't think I want to play 2 of this card. This card's good. I like it. I think it's better than this. It's possible I just don't play these spiders. I do think they're good, and like I said, I think triggering Revolt is okay, but 2/2s are just kind of not great. Ooh, Torch Gauntlet might be really good in my deck. I have two of these, like, great... Oh, yeah. I'm definitely taking Torch Gauntlet. I have, like, these two very good first strikers, and then I also just have double Onslaught. Sideboard card. Definitely not playing two of those. Maybe I'll board in... I'll definitely board in Fog if I'm playing against, like, a token-inspired charge deck. Probably not going to play this main deck. Or that, obviously. Alright. So, this is 27 with 16 creatures. So, if I don't cut any creatures, that means I get, what, 7 spells? I think that's probably enough. I could cut, like, maybe one creature. Because I do also have... I mean, I know the vehicles, like, need more creatures, but 15 creatures is plenty for two vehicles. But then the vehicles, like, especially this train, if it gets a +1 counter or two, I can, like, activate it, then Monstrous Onslaught. So let's see. How many pump spells are in here right now? Just two, I think, right? I think there's a way to... Yeah, there we go. That's a lot of spells. They're, like, kind of creatures, I guess. Maybe I just shouldn't splash black at all. If I don't splash black, I can actually cut both of those. I like that. And then... I think I can afford to cut one creature. Maybe I'll cut a spider. Alright, I like that. So there's the deck. Make sure I'm not forgetting anything. I guess I do need basic land, so let's see. I think I want, like, one more... Wait, this is still 24 cards. Did I... What happened here? I think I just had to cut one more and didn't do it. I feel like I still can cut a creature, but I guess I have these, so I better not cut a creature at this point. So if that's the case, I think it's like Unbridled Growth or Precise Strike. And I think Precise Strike is good because I have like where is it? This guy, Prize Spider, and a Terror of the Fairgrounds. I'm gonna cut the Unbridled Growth. I only have one Revolt card, and I don't really need the fixing. And then I think it's more important to have these guys early. So I'm going to play one more red. I guess... No, that's not right. I mean, it is more important to play these guys early than these guys early. But I have like three or four double green spells, so I definitely want to play an extra forest. Oh, wow, it's saying to go real ham on the forest here. Yeah, I'm just going to play one extra... All right, so there's the deck. I don't know why that's... Oh, because it's still like that. Combined groups. There we go. So yeah, there's the deck. I'll be back in a bit with round one.